Churchill Downs, you are indebted to Saffie Joseph Jr. for something that cannot be compensated with money, his reputation. As a racing enthusiast who keeps track of suspicious trainers, I have never once considered Saffie as a cheater or a trainer who would harm a horse. From an outsider's perspective, I have witnessed a committed horseman who has put in the necessary effort during his relatively short tenure as a trainer in the United States. The issue I have with you, C.D.I., is that you attempted to bury his career along with the headlines. However, the truth remains evident, even if it was not openly acknowledged. While you reinstated him, you are still far from finding a solution to the frequent horse deaths and injuries. Any experienced horseman understands that some deaths are unavoidable in this sport. Years ago, during my time grooming at Laurel, I had a horse that collapsed due to a heart attack while being trained. Another Sunday morning, I discovered a horse with a broken back casted in the stall. Horses are resilient but delicate creatures, and both track officials and state veterinarians must do a better job of ensuring their welfare. Private veterinarians often prioritize their financial interests over morals, exchanging money for compromised horse well-being. Late on Friday, KHRC spokesperson Kristen Voskul confirmed that, based on the evidence collected and provided, the KHRC did not find sufficient grounds to charge Mr. Joseph with any violations. Mr. Joseph's KHRC license remains active. Although the KHRC's press release may appear satisfactory, it cannot replace the vacant stalls or restore one man's reputation. I'd like to know how you feel about this subject or any horse-related matter. Please leave a comment. Thank you for your support.